Hey guys, Scott from therecordingsolution.com. Today I just want to go over a compressor, an audio compressor, and what all the knobs do. This is the first video in a compression series of videos I'm going to do. So I want to break down the knobs so you understand what all these mean, and then you're not confused, and then you can pretty much use every compressor out there, no matter what make and model or what DAW. This is a stock Pro Tools compressor. So let's dive right in. So a compressor is just, a lot of people call it an automatic volume fader. So it helps tame the dynamics in audio. If things get too loud, it'll turn them down. If things are too soft, it'll turn them up. And instead of you having to do it manually, this does it for you. Back in the old days, they used to just have literally a guy who knew the song when they were recording. And he would sit there with a volume knob, and if he knew it was going to be a loud part, he'd turn it down or he'd turn it up. And so someone invented a compressor to do that for you. So let's dive in. So the main control is this threshold knob right here. So you see this arrow right here? That's the threshold knob. And then you see this orange. They're all orange. So you see this orange line? So the threshold sets the line or the level that audio has to pass before any compression starts. So you could have all these knobs set, but if the threshold is not low enough to capture the audio, let me play you, let me set all this to like just some normal, and then I'll play you an audio of a snare. You see how there's no compression going on? When I get down here, now you're seeing this line. That's meaning that's how many dBs of compression is happening, or gain reduction, I'm sorry, is compressing. So right now you're getting about negative 3 dBs of compression, meaning it's turning it down 3 dBs. So the input source, look at the input level, and then the output level. The output level is going to be quieter. Because it's turning it down. So this is the main knob right here. So this just depends on how loud or soft your audio is and how much gain reduction you want. Okay, so that's that control. Your next control is your ratio. Now here's the most confusing, was the most confusing to me when I first started. So let's put it at 3 to 1 ratio, 3.0 to 1 ratio. So that means wherever I have this threshold set, so let's say it's at negative 12 right there. For every 3 dBs, the audio goes over that threshold above this line, it's only going to let 1 dB pass and let you hear it. So it's kind of a low ratio. So it'll take 3 dBs over for you to only hear 1 dB. So the lower the threshold, the less compression you're actually doing to the audio that is past that threshold. Because there's no compression on the audio before the threshold. But once it gets past this threshold line, then the compression kicks on. And then the ratio tells it how much compression to add to that audio that's above this threshold. And so right now it's only takes 2 dBs over that threshold for you to hear 1 dB. So that's not a high, that's not a lot of compression. Now when you're doing a lot of compression, like 7 to 1, 8 to 1, that's like smashing it. I mean, you're getting super heavy over here. So it would take 28 dBs over that threshold line, or 29 dBs over that threshold line, for you to be able to hear 1 dB of audio. So it's squashing your audio. So just know that the lower the ratio, the less compression, the higher ratio, the more compression, okay? And when you get to these high levels, you're pretty much limiting. I'm not going to go into that right now, but it's like totally squashing it, not letting anything pass that threshold. So that's the ratio. Then we have the next knobs you need to worry about are the attack and release. So attack and release, it just has fast attack. On this one, it's all the way to the left is a fast, super fast, and all the way to the right is a slow attack. Now, if you wanted to, say, on a snare drum, it naturally has a loud transient, like a spike in volume, right at the beginning, and then it dies off. So that first transient is right when the stick hits the snare. So say you had a snare drum that you wanted to be fatter, for example, and you wanted to make the tail of that snare drum, like the decay of that snare drum, as audible as the attack of that snare drum, well, you would want to kind of have a faster attack so that it kind of hits that initial transient. And then you would want like a slower release. So the compressor is going to clamp down fast, and then it's going to hold on. So here's the release. I'm going a little bit slower. It's going to hold on all the way through the tail before it releases. And then however much dB of gain reduction you have. So let's try this. This is a snare drum. So we're getting about -3 to -4 dBs of gain reduction. So I am attacking that initial transient, releasing it a little bit slower, and so it's like evening out the wavelength, if that makes sense. Let me zoom in here. So you see these wavelengths right here? I don't want to go too far. You have this initial attack right here, and then it dies down like a triangle. So you would attack it to where it clamped down right here, and then a slower release, so it's holding on right there. And then you would bring up the gain knob. So whatever, how many dBs it's reducing the volume. So we say 3 to 4. So I want to bring it up 3 to 4 dBs to make up that volume. They call it makeup gain. And so what it's essentially doing, you're not going to see it right here, but in the actual audio example, it's squashing this transient to make it a little bit more even with the tail, and then bringing up the overall volume of the whole snare hit, so it's more like a rectangle shape. So the audio level of the transient and the tail are going to be the same level. Let's go right here. This is a better example right here. Now, if you see, the output and the input are almost the same now, because originally it was turning the output down 3 to 4 dBs, and you saw that difference, but we made up the makeup gain with this knob. And so now the input and the output are the same. And it's very subtle, but if I turn it off, the snare gets a little quieter, but the input and output are the same, but it sounds louder with this and fuller. Very subtle, and we're barely doing any compression, 1.8 to 1. So I'm just trying to explain you what the knobs do. So you have your threshold, again, that sets where it starts to compress. The ratio tells it how much to compress. The attack and release tell you how fast or how slow to attack. Now, if you wanted that transient to come through even more, you would do a slower attack before the compressor kicks on. So some audio would pass through past the threshold line, because before the compressor kicks on, it has a slower attack, so it would wait milliseconds. We're talking very fast amount of time here, milliseconds, before it clamps down. If you have a slower attack, it would let a little bit of that audio and transient pass through that over that threshold before it clamps down, and then you can set the how fast you want to release. If it's like a fast song and you got a lot of transients, things happening really fast, and you don't want the compressor to hold on, and you want it to sound musical and not sound squashed, and you can sometimes you can noticeably hear the compressor working hard and trying to keep up with the audio, you would want kind of a fast release. And I'll go into more details in later videos of different examples, but when you're thinking about compression and when you're like you want to ask yourself, why am I compressing this? Why am I having a faster or slower attack? Why do I need a faster or slower release? And as you learn more about compression and different types of compression on different instruments, you'll start gaining that knowledge, and that'll be a part of your tools and your arsenal of the different settings you would use for different circumstances. So, and then you have the knee. Now, the knee is just like how hard or soft. You have hard knees and soft knees. It just says knee here, that the audio is going to be clamped down. So if the attack and release are how fast and how slow, the knee is just how hard and how soft. So if you look right now, this is a hard knee. Let me set this. You see, here's the audio. And then when it hits the threshold, it's like a quick diagonal line, like a point. So that's a hard knee. Now, softer knee, watch this area right here. It's going to round off. See, now it's more, that's a completely soft knee. So now it's more of like a natural soft curve. So what that means is once the audio passes that threshold, it's going to gradually, and we say it takes longer, or it's going to take a more gradual time for you to hear that compression. We're talking milliseconds, guys. It's going to happen super fast. Either we do a hard knee or soft knee. But if you have a lot of compression going on and you have a super hard knee, as soon as the audio passes that threshold, you're going to noticeably hear a difference. And if you want it to be a more subtle difference, like maybe you're doing a vocal, you would kind of want the knee to be a little bit softer so it sounds more natural and it's more of like a natural compression line and curve. So that's all the knee is. And that is pretty much it, okay? So again, let's recap. Threshold sets the actual line, the line in the sand that audio has to cross before any compression happens, okay? And then the ratio tells you how much compression is added to that audio that passes the threshold line. Once it passes that threshold line, how much compression do you want? The lower, the less compression. The higher, the more compression. The attack and release tell you how fast to attack and how slow to attack, and how fast to release and how slow to release. And we'll go into more details of different instruments and why you would want a faster or slower attack in different circumstances. And then when you set all these and you're actually getting some gain reduction here, -3, -6 dBs of gain reduction, meaning it's turning the audio down by that much, then you use the makeup gain, because when you have the audio being turned down, you're going to hear it, and then you use the makeup gain to turn up that volume you lost, however many dBs of gain reduction you are getting, make it the same. So if you're getting -3 dBs of gain reduction, turn the makeup gain -3 dBs, and then you're back where your input level and your output level are the same, but you have the effect of the compression happening. And then if you want a soft knee or hard knee, if you want a more aggressive compression sound, or do you want a more gentle, more natural sound, okay? So those are the controls of a compressor. And I know it's confusing at first. I still get confused sometimes, but as I teach it and as I practice it and put it in real world audio examples, you start learning and then your head starts wrapping around it. So I wanted to make this video so you can have a reference video if you ever needed it. And this is going to be on the blog post and the article with same. If you're more of a reader and you learn by reading, then you're going to have the video here and the words and the actual blog post and article on the site. So, but this is on YouTube right now. So I want to thank you for watching. Please hit the subscribe button and hit that little bell. I don't know what the heck the bell is for anymore, but it gives us more. If you're subscribed to my channel and you hit the bell, once I release a video, then you will be notified. If you don't hit the bell, you're not going to be notified. So make sure you hit that bell and share it with a friend. Sign up to the site, become part of the tribe. I have a free ebook that shows you how to set up a home studio. Right now, I got a free EQ chart that breaks down all the frequencies and different instruments and their problematic and ideal frequencies. And we're probably going to have some kind of compression chart up there for free as well, and all kinds of free stuff in the future. So go grab a free whatever's there right now. Become part of the tribe, and you'll also be put on my weekly email list where you'll get free tutorials and tips and tricks and all kinds of good stuff delivered right to your inbox each week. Thanks for watching. Thanks for your attention. Scott from TheRecordingSolution.com. We'll see you on the other side.